So here's what I want you to do, God helping you. Take your ordinary life, your everyday walking around, eating, sleeping, going to work life, and place it before God as an offering. Embracing what God does for you is the best thing you can do for Him. Don't become so well-adjusted to your culture that you fit into it without even thinking. Instead, fix your attention on God and you'll be changed from the inside out. Readily recognize what He wants from you and quickly respond to it. Unlike the culture around you always dragging you down to its level of immaturity, God brings the best out of you. He develops well-formed maturity in you. I'm speaking to you out of deep gratitude for all that God has given me, and especially as I have responsibility in relation to you. Living then as every one of you does in pure grace, it's important that you not misinterpret yourself as people who are bringing this goodness to God. No, God brings it all to you. The only accurate way to understand ourselves is by what God is and what He does for us, not by what we are and what we do for Him. In this way, we are like various parts of the human body. Each part gets its meaning from the body as a whole, and not the other way around. The body we're talking about is Christ's body of chosen people. Each of us finds our meaning and our function as a part of His body. But as a chopped off finger or a cut off toe, we wouldn't amount to much, would we? So, since we find ourselves fashioned into all these excellently formed and marvelously functioning parts in Christ's body, let's just go ahead and be what we were made to be, without enviously or pridefully comparing ourselves with each other and trying to be something that we aren't. If you preach, just preach God's message, nothing else. And if you help, just help. Don't take over. If you teach, stick to your teaching. And if you give encouraging guidance, be careful you don't get bossy. If you're called to be put in charge, don't manipulate. If you're called to give aid to people, keep your eyes open and be quick to respond. And if you work with the disadvantaged, don't let yourself get irritated or become depressed by them. Keep a smile on your face. Love from the center of who you are. Don't fake it. Run for dear life from evil and hold on to dear life for good. Be good friends who love deeply. Practice playing second fiddle. Don't burn out. Keep yourselves fueled and aflame. Be alert servants of the Master, cheerfully expectant. Don't quit in hard times. Pray all the harder. And help needy Christians be inventive in hospitality. Bless your enemies. No cursing under your breath. Laugh with your happy friends when they're happy, and share tears when they're down. Get along with each other. Don't be stuck up. Make friends with the nobodies. Don't be the great somebody. Don't hit back. Discover beauty in everyone. And if you've got it in you, get along with everybody. Don't insist on getting even. That's not for you. I'll do the judging, God says. I'll take care of it. Our scripture tells us that if you see your enemy hungry, go buy that man lunch. Or if he's thirsty, buy him a drink. Your generosity will surprise him. And don't let evil get the best of you. Get the best of evil by doing good.